Good day! Today, we are going to talk about the Clean Water Act of 2004, or also called as the Republic Act 9275. So first, let us know what is the Republic Act 9275. Republic Act 9275 is an act of providing a comprehensive water quality management and for other purposes. And this act also pursue a policy of economic growth in a manner consistent with the protection, preservation, and revival of the quality of our fresh, brackish, and marine waters. This Republic Act was signed by President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo last March 22, 2004, and it took effect last May 6, 2004. This act seeks to protect water bodies in the country from contamination from different land-based sources, and it also aims for an analytical and comprehensive plan to reduce and minimize pollution through a multi-sectoral and participatory approach involving all stakeholders. So why is this act needed? Monitoring of the country's rivers as early as 1996 found that only 51% of the rivers identified still met the standards for their beneficial use. The remainder had already been polluted by domestic, industrial, and agricultural sources. Many reports and studies point to the fact that 48% of domestic wastewater is a major source of organic pollution. The degradation of water quality from domestic waste composed of 80% BOD. Only 3% of investments in water supply and sanitation ended up going to sanitation and treatment of sewage. It is also needed because of the spread of waterborne diseases, since 31% of all diseases in the world are due to contaminated waters. And lastly, the decline in fish production. Fish kills because of increase in BOD levels, sedimentation, and silt pollution. That is why it is essential for the government to have a detailed method to secure water quality in the Philippines. So given with the Republic Act, how will it manage the water quality? Water quality control can either be focused on watershed, river basin, or area of water supplies. This is within coordination with the National Water Resources Board, or NWRB. And lastly, DNR shall designate water quality management areas with specific hydrological, hydrogeological, meteorological, or geographical conditions that affect the reaction and diffusion of contaminants in water bodies. How will discharge of wastewater be controlled and discouraged? So all owners or managers of wastewater discharging facilities are expected to obtain a DENR or Laguna Lake Development Authority discharge permit. And existing industries without a permit are given 12 months from the effectiveness of the implementing rules and regulations promulgated in accordance with this act to secure a discharge permit. Anyone who discharges wastewater into a body of water would have to pay a fee for wastewater, and through this economic instrument, it will promote investors in cleaner production and pollution control technologies to reduce the amount of pollutants produced and released. Those whose wastewater discharge is better than the water quality standards of the receiving body of water would also receive bonuses. Physical and non-physical incentives will also be granted to LGUs, water districts, enterprises, private organizations, and individuals developing and implementing an outstanding and innovative water quality management project. How will domestic wastewater be addressed? LGUs shall provide the land, including road, right of the way for the construction of sewage or septic treatment facilities, and shall collect funds for the operation and maintenance of such facilities. The Metropolitan Water Works and Sewage System, or MWSS, and other agencies authorized to provide water supply and sewerage services would be required to connect existing sewage lines, subject to payment of sewerage service charges, fees within 5 years of the Act being effective. So what are the safeguards provided for? As part of their environmental management plan, all possible dischargers are required to set up an Environmental Guarantee Fund, or the EGF. The EGF would fund watershed and aquifer conservation, emergency response, cleanup, or recovery needs. What are the different government departments that will help implement this Republic Act? There are 8 different government departments. First is the DENR, or the Department of Environmental and Natural Resources. This department is the primary agency responsible for the implementation of the Clean Water Act. Next is the enforcement of water quality standards in marine waters, specifically from offshore sources, which will be handled by the Philippine Coast Guard. Next is the DPWH, or the Department of Public Works and Highways. Together with the DENR and LGUs, DPWH shall prepare a national program on sewerage and septage management. Next is the Department of Agriculture, or the DOA. They develop guidelines for reuse of wastewater for irrigation purposes or soil conditioner or fertilizer. Next is the DOE, or the Department of Energy. Together with the DENR, DOE shall formulate water quality criteria and standards specifically for geothermal exploration. Next is the DOH, or the Department of Health. They provide specific health criteria and data related to the promulgation, revision, and enforcement of drinking water quality standards. Next is the DOST, or the Department of Science and Technology. They shall prepare a program for the evaluation, verification, development, and public dissemination of pollution prevention and cleaner production technology. And lastly is the DepEd, CHED, and Philippine Information Agency, or PIA, will prepare and implement a comprehensive and continuing public education and information program. What are the different prohibited acts for this Republic Act? There are 13 prohibited acts. What are the penalties and fines if this act will be violated? Anyone who performs prohibited actions such as discharging untreated wastewater into any water body will be fined for each day of violation. The amount of no less than 10,000 pesos but not more than 200,000 pesos. Failure or refusal to clean up resulting in serious injury, loss of life, or leading to irreversible contamination of surface, soil, coastal, and marine water shall be punished with the imprisonment of not less than 6 years and 1 day and not more than 12 years, and a fine of 500,000 per day for each day the contamination or omission continues. Failure to carry out willfully cleanup operations shall be punished by imprisonment of not less than 2 years and not more than 4 years. It also requires a fine of no less than 50,000 pesos and no more than 100,000 pesos per day of violation. In case of gross violation, for each day of violation, a fine of not less than 500,000 pesos but not more than 3 million pesos will be imposed. Even criminal charges can be filed. Lastly, what are the challenges in implementing this act? So basically, the Republic Act 9275 or the Clean Water Act of 2004 aims to protect the country's water bodies from pollution from land-based sources such as the industrial, commercial establishment, agriculture, and community or household activities. Clean Water Act protects more than just the water. It understands, value, protect the ecosystem, and more than that, our life. Thank you for listening.